Just Kevin Robinson with an update now, Kev.
Yeah, I want to update our viewers really quick on what's happening here in the WLWT viewing area. There was a tornado watch that was in effect for Union County. That was the only county that was under a tornado watch. I do not expect severe weather in the WLWT viewing area as we go through the overnight hours. That's the good news. The bad news is we are getting some very nasty reports of damage out of the Dayton area, with words such as major and severe damage now being reported to homes and some other businesses, things of that nature, up and around the Montgomery County area, just north of downtown Dayton. This is the thunderstorm we're tracking. And again, this is about as bad as it gets when you're seeing this on radar here. I want to show you this particularly nasty looking Hook Echo here. And you don't even have to be a meteorologist to see that this is a tornado. This is not a Doppler radar, but a confirmed tornado here with a dangerous signature on it, heading off towards the east southeast. So Old Town, Xenia next could be in line here. This very dangerous storm just to the north of Beaver Creek right now. Again, a very strong signature on radar. This storm has moved from around the Trotwood area in northwest Dayton, just south of I-70, just north of downtown Dayton, where the National Weather Service is reporting highway cameras, the ODOT cameras along I-75, wiped out at least five of them here as the storm crossed Interstate 75. Undoubtedly, there's going to be some significant and really, I would say, catastrophic damage across parts of the Dayton area with what appears to be a large tornado now that continues to move in the direction of Old Town and Xenia. So again, very nasty scenario. Look at this, folks. I mean, I gotta be honest with you. Here in our area, we rarely see signatures this strong on radar for a tornado. And look at this. When we talk about gate-to-gate shear or the couplet on the radar here, we're talking about the reds and greens. I can't tell you the last time I've seen here in recent memory where we've had red, greens, and blues on a signature like this on radar. These are the type of signatures we typically see out in parts of Texas and Oklahoma with some of the severe weather we've been seeing happen out there for the past week or so. So very frightening situation here across Montgomery County, now moving into Greene County. This again outside of our viewing area, but something we will continue to watch here over the next couple of hours. So bring it back close to home. Fortunately for us, a lot quieter scenario. Temperatures are in the mid 70s. It's very warm. It's very humid out. In fact, it still feels like it's close to 80 degrees for most of us in the viewing area. So quiet through the night, but warm and muggy. Temperatures are going to remain in the low 70s for the most part, under partly to mostly cloudy skies. So here we are, 77 degrees. We've got ourselves a nice southwesterly wind. In fact, these storms, we were tracking them at 5 and 6 up around Chicago, basically have been riding right along this warm front here into central Ohio. Watch what happens on Futurecast. Keeps it quiet for us, fortunately, through the night. I think as you get your Tuesday started, you're back to school, you're back to work, things are relatively quiet. There may be, you know, one or two kind of stray pop-up storms in the afternoon. Otherwise, it should be fairly quiet. Now, as we get into Wednesday and Thursday, that's our active weather days. Wednesday and Thursday, we are likely to see showers and thunderstorms. I think most of us get wet, whereas tomorrow there could be a pop-up storm here or there, but I think Wednesday and Thursday are two wettest days this week before we get a break from the humidity and storms, at least for a few days. So 67 for a low tonight underneath partly cloudy skies. And then tomorrow, 86 for an afternoon high. Small chance for a pop-up storm. Here's your day planner. It should warm up pretty quickly tomorrow. Remember, in the sun, it will feel like it's close to about 90 degrees. So here's your 7-day forecast. We've got the weather impact days on Wednesday and Thursday, and then it looks cooler and less humid. A break from all the nasty weather just in time for the weekend.
All right, Kevin, thank you. Some firepower.